So it's interesting from that perspective, but it doesn't kind of know that the engine is going to go into the direction. High performance, high efficiency, and so on. And
thank you. pictures. So what is this? Tell us.
So I did the benchmarks for MongoDB. I used sysbench and range updates. It's a simple
So this is a query which updates a range of roles?
Yes.
And these are seconds?
Yes,
Conservative number, we don't want people to, so you can set it much higher, like 32 megabytes or so.
Can we set the high number? we do is we have a lower bound and higher bound, a lower threshold, and one is keep the lower threshold, it starts to slow down. And when we hit the higher threshold, it starts to the full stop, and then we go slower and slower in that range. So yeah, this kind of soft and hard thing. We don't have plan to say, without hitting the slowdown threshold, we're actively slow down. We don't have such a plan. Yeah, this is something we can consider, which we don't do enough. Yes, it's also possible that the default compaction cannot catch up because and cause this slowdown condition to trigger too soon. Yeah, too many compaction may slow down. Well, yes, you can do both. I think I get all these questions, like, well, so you have to kind of things you need to consider. You need to consider the compaction work, the number of threads, and then the slowdown condition. One of the things we're actually thinking about is how to make this easier for you to use. One thing would be helpful. Hopefully, we can get better. But yes, now we have to consider all these things, how to make compaction more simple. Several knobs you can try. How to make this slow down what's the bridge just to trigger this is
reasonable events and so on. So none of this discussion should be happening. This is this kind of the goal for in production after rollout, especially for higher demand cases? For some of the systems where we're deploying today, there is not that much of need to have super high write rate that we have to support. It's more about the space efficiency project. But as we go further and we look at MyRocks as this thing that goes for the ability of our endurance and write rate and super high write performance, we definitely want to see this year. Most of these things are machine time, beautiful, smooth, beautiful work.
I just want to point out that this has been a problem within OBD for a long time. And Cortona did a lot of work to document the problem and to fix it and go to the world to fix it. So it's not a new problem with us.
I have a question, Mark. So you are working with Cortona on courses that are RocksDB servers.
Can
Cortona
do the same for Rocks? Well, do I expect them to help make it better?
Yeah.
I hope so. If nothing else, good performance reports showing wrong, nobody has to get better. But even in my current testing, so I do see more jitter, more variance with my Rocks. But the worst case outliers, like the multi-second stalls, are much more prominent for me within ODB, even in ODB in my sister cassette, I'm still getting more frequent than I am in my box. It's not that first 50 better than that.
So you're saying even with this spikes, it's
the drops?
The configuration parameters that are there are not fully updated. We should get better at that when the G spot and the videos that I share called out.
So we have a new presenter?
I think Mark has a very good conclusion about this thing. So first, this thing with some RocksDB tuning, it can be much better. And this is not good for you to always tune it. So we're going to work this year to make it automatically done.
Yes, I will
yeah. In case you're not aware of that, so there's a there are bunch of RocksDB tuning parameters which is hard to find. So there's a wiki by the MyRocks. So there's a wiki on Facebook, MyRocks wiki, and there's a section for the MyRocks tuning. And we introduced a bunch of parameters to set the MyRocks specific tuning option. So MyRocks come back two different components. One is the DB options, and the other is kind of family specific options. And both are RocksDB specific. So for example, the broadcast size, it's similar to the buffer size. So this is a DB specific option and can be set at like this. And there's also huge number of company specific options that you can configure the company options by long strings. And these actually affect the performance a lot. So tuning this may indicate, for example, writing less on compaction. So the default value is not as optimal for benchmarks. So we are trying to make it better, and make the default value better for the default samples.
So would anybody tell me how to set the level of ratio between levels? So is it, what is the group size ratio between like?
I forgot.
Yeah, so I'm asking not about the parameter name, but the guidance.
Yes, by default it's 10x difference between levels. And if you can increase to 4x, for example, or increase to 20, 25,
yeah, but why would I do that? So what they, I know from Mark that they usually run at 4 or 5. Why wouldn't you do it for me? I mean, how do I find out?
Sorry, Mark, you have to say it a second time.
I'd rather not tell you because I don't want people to hear me. It's pretty good at that. 20 would increase write amplification and decrease space amplification. The increase in write amplification would be significant. The decrease in space amplification, the benefit, would be small. So it's a big cost with a small benefit.
You're also going to improve rhythm. The bigger the size ratio, it's the better the reach. It's half. Why do you think rhythm always?
You're going to have, you potentially might have one less level than your LSM.
Yeah.
But that's at least.
But by the same reason, you could have 3 or 4 as a. Why is it 10?
Why is it 10?
Yes.
Because I think it's a good spot. Well, it's 10 because level DB centers. But I also think it's a pretty good spot on the spectrum of space, write, and read efficiency.
So anybody has any done?
There's no mathematical proof of it. I don't think you could have a proof of it. And well, let me just say one more thing. So for the talk, I've been running tests. I had an upgrade of CentOS 6 to 7, so I had to rerun everything. The results were odd. I didn't like the kernel, so I upgraded the kernel, had to rerun everything. I do a lot of cross-product testing, so there's a lot of additional tests that I don't share results for. A lot of them don't show anything interesting. But, you know, additional, can I test for fan-out? I would call this ratio of fan-out. I could do fan-out testing, and I've done it in the past, with 4, 8, 10, 20, and yeah, get another set of results to look at. From my perspective, 10 is a good size.
So I wonder whether it's, it could be automatically changing. But there is a question.
Hi,
Sam.
My question is, are there any recommendations about how to choose the amount of level depending on the DB size? And what amount should we use, for example, to decrease write amplification? What amount do you, we should use to increase read performance and so on? Are there any recommendations about this?
So the number of levels would be determined by the fan out, the growth factor between levels.
Yes.
And the size of level one. And I think default, the size of level one is 256 meg or 512 meg. Which is a pretty, for sizing, I try to set size of level 0 and size of level 1 to be similar. And that's frequently means I end up with, let's say, 512 meg for level 1. If I then have a 10x fan-out growth ratio, then 5 gig would be level 2,
yeah,
50 gig, and then so you can go it from there. But the two things that determine the number of levels, fan-out and size of level 1.
You mentioned the size of level 1 is 512 megabytes. Is there any dependence between this size and the size of DB? Should we choose, for example, 10 levels for DB, or maybe 20 levels or 100 levels?
I would prefer to have far less. Many less than 10. So hopefully I would try to stick to 5 levels.
I'm
say something. We may plan to improve this a little bit. So this LSM tree math is like what we have discussed, very complicated, and you have multiple metrics you need to think about, length, amplification, read, and space, and we plan to make that a little bit better in terms of tuning.
Some of the other questions. Suzanne, I think that's something that's very, very sharp. So I have like a one terabyte SSD, I can have one big ass RocksDB, I can have 1,000 ones that are older. In some ways, I think it seems better to have smaller ones, but I feel like so I don't know that information. But I know that there's got to be a downside, and people have to be extremely tiny ones. What should we be looking at? What's the guidance on, like, if I could arbitrarily choose to make 2 gigs plus 10 gigs plus 100 gigs plus 500 gigs, and I know I'm not going to mix across because otherwise that wouldn't work. It's an SSD, so yeah, but that's a much better. I mean, I have multiple ones.
How many, the numbers that you were given though, like,
well, it's interesting,
it's going to be NFSense, so it's a question of is it going to be NFSense across fewer wall files. So yes, it does make a difference, definitely. I'm more curious if you guys play with this. I can't imagine what the first people thinking about this.
I can try to put something here. So there are multiple, definitely having multiple shards on a system helps just because you have more domains that you can operate. So if you're lucky, you can have that many replication streams, which is great. You can have that many, like, distributed lock contention if there is any. So if you're in our, like, the mode, like, heaviest, right, you know, if you want to win a benchmark, you definitely go on and have multiple shards of multiple instances of RocksDB. And you're lucky, like, you partition buffer pool in the DB, or you know, have multiple transactions. But definitely having, you know, just from pure lock contention perspective helps. At the same time, you just don't want to have too small ones because if you have an outline behavior, you just end up with a ghetto where you are just trashing your instance for no reason whatsoever. Right? So if you want just a rule of thumb how to partition your terabyte, I was just like, oh, do you know 20 congrats. It doesn't really matter much, but you just have to, like, 1,000 is definitely an overkill. At the same time, you have these manageable units that you can then treat individually, and it kind of helps over time. And of course, that is the question of when you talk about, like, log fsyncs. If you are fsyncing every transaction anyway, it doesn't matter. And then the grouping again, the efficiency of, like, you still have to do enough on a really busy system. Your system will, a single thread will still produce many writes a second. So you don't get any. So it makes sense to split it. Having super large one may have, like, mathematical like the algorithm will be, like, really smooth, and it will source types better, but at the same time it doesn't really matter.
So I'll say this. So assuming you have the same memory budget to do the write buffer mem table size, that and everything scaled down, once you have more shards, everything scaled down, the level zero size scaled down by that ratio, and level one scaled down to that ratio, and then everything should be the same. But usually people don't scale down. Usually, like, for example, usually they use 64 megabytes mem table size for 100 shards and still use 64 for 10 shards or 1,000 shards, and then the math changes. I think that might be the reason why people usually see better performance when there's more shards. There's also other factors, like there's single shard as constant things like we cannot do parallels well. And you have, for example, the writing, if you see one thread write to the post is not good enough, having more shards, different threads writing to multiple DBs is much faster. That's another consideration some other people want. So I guess it's in terms of performance, it's easier to get better for more shards than smaller shards. But operationally, it's up to your application.
Sometimes there's some hidden 2 megabyte second limit that you could help it to increase. Now we have the fact that more time. We are not at the level of maturity that we would just completely ignore that.
Okay.
I'm thinking about trying this in a monitoring system storing time series data that I want to automatically page out. I think that sounds awesome, having that as a feature in the database. Is that in RocksDB right now? You can set that TTL value and that actually works? Or is that some theory thing I didn't understand?
There is. So in MyRocks, we're still working on that. I don't understand that. But from RocksDB, talking about how
to. So in MySQL, it's not there yet. Okay.
Is there a nice call for tables only have primary? For tables with only a primary key.
For tables with primary key?
I can swing that. Yeah. I can swing that. I'll start with that.
That's still really cool. In general, it sounds like RocksDB is that's a good use case for storing a bunch of time sensitive data, right? It's a bunch of little records and shit, right?
It's a pretty common use case in RocksDB, so lots of people use RocksDB that way.
Okay.
Okay, anybody else?
A bit more seriously, it depends. It depends on what kind of user we are looking at. If you're okay with open source or getting a package and then you're on your own, then soon to be